Why spend $10, $20, even $50 on expensive decorations for your wedding when you can make them yourself using simple materials? Pipe cleaner and tissue paper. All you do is you fold this, and you take this and tie it around, twisting it back, and you cut here. These tissues come in a whole rainbow of colors, girls, allowing you a wonderful opportunity to use your imagination in decorating. And no one will ever know you made them yourselves. Then, in no time at all, your reception room will have the look of a high society wedding. And on our next show, ladies, I'll be demonstrating how to make petit fours and punch for your post-nuptial celebration. And not to mention the fact, folks, you won't want to miss a special announcement I'm planning to make, which will prove that all of these wedding pointers were well-researched firsthand. Until then.
Ginger and I learned how to make those flowers in fifth grade art class. Then we made 4 dozen of them for Hank's wedding. Do you remember?
Ginger knows very much about weddings.
She's an expert.
She's planned 3 weddings on her own and never made it to the altar yet. I think she's going all the way this time. But don't take it personally, Mutt.
I'm very sorry, Jeff.
For everybody's information, it's no skin off my nose if Ginger gets married.
You got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to be affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark,
Jonah in the whale, Noah in the ark.
What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said you got to accent.
You ain't the positive healer. Mine ain't the negative and last on. To be affirmative,
don't mess with Mr. In-Between.
I'm sorry you're getting divorced.
Yes, well, c'est la vie. I'm sure there's an Italian equivalent. Okay, sera, sera, or whatever. Of course, I will be keeping my married name. It means a great deal in this area. And it means a great deal, of course, for your daughter, too.
Emma will always love her grandparents.
I'm referring to the fact that no one ever need know that my granddaughter is half Jewish. Not that there's anything wrong with being half Jewish, but you know as well as I do that there are those who carry prejudice against your people. Why, there are schools, clubs, of course, that deny admission to anyone with an Hebraic background. And why should anyone keep dear little Emma out of anything just because she's half Jewish? And of course, they won't be able to if they don't know she is. And with a name like Emma Sloan, who could guess?
Emma is all Jewish.
Why do you say that?
If the mother is Jewish, then the baby is Jewish in our religion.
But not in our religion, and my family constitutes half of that child's genes. And I'm certainly willing to let Emma decide for herself when she grows up.
It does not matter, even if Emma decides to be Episcopal, still...
Episcopalian.
No matter, she's still Jewish.
A Jewish Episcopalian. Isn't that a contradiction in terms?
I think it is correct to say an Episcopalian Jew.
Well, to be Episcopalian and still be 100% Jewish doesn't make any sense on the face of it, unless it's not a religious question.
It is religion. But Jewish is also what I am.
Well, your passport says Italian. Does that mean nothing?
I am Italian, but also Jewish.
I'm a forward-thinking person, Gina. I have Jewish friends. I pride myself on my open-mindedness, but I fail to understand your stubbornness.
I do not completely understand myself. I did not think about it before the war.
You were not religious?
No. But it did not matter to the Nazis. They did not ask, do you believe in God? Also, they did not ask, are you religious? Only they ask, you are Jewish.
Well, you certainly don't want to accept the Nazis' argument about what constitutes being Jewish.
No, I only mean they did not give me a choice. They taught me, the Nazis teach me, that no matter what I say, no matter what I do, no matter what I believe, I am still Jewish. And eventually I realize I want to be Jewish because I do not want to give the Nazis even a little small victory.
You're not considering going to Palestine?
No. Emma is born here. Emma is American.
100% American, I should say.
And also 100% Jewish.
Well, we've come full circle, haven't we?
Have we done so far?
Almost $30.
Well, maybe it'll pick up at dinner time.
People don't eat out on Sunday nights. They have a big meal after church.
At home? The only way you're going to make any money is to be open all week, not just on the weekend.
Being open every day doesn't guarantee that people will eat here every day, Mother.
Being closed guarantees they won't.
We've been round and round on this, Mother. The only way we can be open every day is if one of us quits our job with the Sloans. And if we quit our job and don't do enough business during the week and had to survive on one paycheck, we'd lose everything.
My word. There he is. All he ever does is scare the customers away, makes them nervous, as if he's looking for trouble.
Makes me nervous, too. All he ever orders is coffee.
Maybe he won't come in. Just our luck.
Good afternoon. Coffee?
Please.
Thank you for coming. You come on back again.
And how about a piece of apple cobbler fresh out of the oven?
All right.
With all the customers he's losing us, we may as well charge him for a whole cobbler.
Mr. Brandstetter said the buttons I need to fix your yellow blouse should be in by Thursday. I have it for you as soon as they come in.
You're not to pay me till your husband gets another job.
Well, you have to earn a living.
I will not take your money now, only later.
Oh, God bless you. Here, at least take some cookies with you. If you can think of any way I can repay the favor, be sure to let me know.
Thank you. Can I come out this way, Al?
Sure. All finished?
I told your wife not to pay me until you get another job.
You may need more patience than Job needed.
Maybe it will not be that long.
From your lips to some employer's ears.
I'm sorry for what has happened to you. It is not fair. But hopefully those fit will hit Ibergen.
You've got more faith than I do, sister, but that wouldn't take much because I am rapidly losing faith in human nature. Although I'll admit you got me on a bad day. Week. Month.
May I ask you a question? I do not intend to be rude.
Fire away.
Does it bother you to live in a house where there are so many statues and crosses and Christian symbols?
No.
Why?
Why should it?
Because it is not your tradition.
Well, I'm not religious, so those things I look at the same way I'd look at a rabbit's foot or any other good luck charm. They don't hurt me. It might make someone else comfortable or happy, and when my son is old enough, I'll tell him exactly how I feel about them.
But would you also tell him of our tradition?
The parts I agree with.
What does this mean?
With all due respect, there's been a lot done in the name of tradition that I don't agree with.
What is it that you do not like about Judaism?
I'm not picking on Judaism, per se. I have an equal affection for all religions. None.
Is this not what Americans say is, spilling the baby out with the water from the bath?
It's being even-handed.
But how can you think that it is possible to turn your back on so many hundreds of years of tradition?
How can you think it's not possible?
No reason you should be the last to know. Mrs. Sloan has decided she wants a divorce.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Mr. Sloan.
Very sorry, sir.
Well, not nearly as sorry as I am, but the point is, I will soon be taking up residence elsewhere. Would you please pack up that old set of dishes that we never use? I'll take them with me.
Yes, sir.
You can use that to wrap them.
Don't touch those dishes. Those were a wedding gift from my cousin. And I suppose Mr. Sloan told you to use today's newspaper, which I haven't finished reading yet. Abe, go straight out and buy another copy and ask for the change for it from Mr. Sloan and remind him that he is not the only human being on Earth who keeps up on the day's events. Gloria, unpack those dishes immediately. And then I want everything in the front hall hauled out to the incinerator.
Yes, ma'am.
Where are you going with my fishing hat?
To the incinerator.
You are most certainly not. My back issues of field and stream. Put those back this instant. If you want to throw something out, throw out the damn sheet music.
Hello, Charlie, come
here. Hi. Hi, Emma. Look what I got you. Yep. It's Easter Bunny himself. You're going to be your own one girl Easter parade. Well, what's all this, Gina? You're not going to eat now, are you? Gloria said she's going to watch Emma while we're at the movies. And if we leave right away, we can catch the first feature.
I do not wish to go to the movies tonight.
Oh, come on, Gina. You want Emma to be an American. It's an old American custom. Movies on Friday night.
I also have a custom.
Which is?
I would like for you to be with us while we light the Sabbath candles.
I bet you I walked up and down those stairs 100 times today.
They can't agree on anything.
Gloria, would you take the green standing lamp from the master bedroom and put it with my things in the guest bedroom? Good heavens, Gloria. Why is my bedroom lamp in the guest room? Put it back where it belongs. I distinctly remember telling you to put that lamp in the guest bedroom. I don't care what Mr. Sloan said. We've got to quit that job before we're old and gray. Can you imagine if someone treated them the way they treat us?
Ruth? Mike?
Yes,
Mr. Davis. Yes, Mr. Davis.
A discussion is in order. For some time now, Mr. Davis and I have been concerned about the way you do your jobs. I would like to show you this.
You do know what that is, I suppose. A cookie.
A cookie which has sat atop the credenza in the living room for 3 days, unnoticed. Another under our bed is still there. And a third on the front stoop near the Ilex Hexi was there for 48 hours before it was discovered and removed.
And who knows whether some neighborhood pet didn't eat it.
We can only be glad it's not summer and we're not plagued by ants.
How did the cookies get in all these places?
I put them there as a test. A test which you both failed. The question was how thorough your cleaning is. The answer is your work leaves a lot to be desired.
A success of Rupert's and something like that just might come to pass.
Oh,
Kata Alanoi Elchainu Elch Halom Asher Kirishanu Vamitzvotav Bitsivanu Lahadlech Ne'er Sher Shabbat.
What does that mean?
I know in Italian.
Well, my Italian's as good as my Hebrew, Gina.
It praises the God that gives us the commandments and requires that we must light the Sabbath candles. And I say to you, Shabbat Shalom, which means may the peace of the Sabbath be with you. And you say to me, Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you. And now you may say a prayer blessing for Emma.
God bless you, my beautiful little pumpkin.
Here's how we do it. I will read it to you in English. May God make you as Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord shine his countenance upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord favor you and grant you peace.
Now can we eat?
Now we share the challah.
Looks like egg bread.
After a blessing.
Whoa, Emma, if we have to bless every dish, we'll never get to dessert.
Baruch atah Adonai Elohenu melech halom amotzi lechemin horitz.
That's thanks for the food, am I right?
Yes. There is more to the Sabbath evening, but we will do more eventually when Em understands more.
What about this?
That should be filled with wine. It should be that the father of the family says the Kiddush prayer over it. It should be that Emma's father does this.
Asleep.
Thank you for keeping the Sabbath with us.
Thank you for inviting me.
You don't mind that it is a Jewish tradition?
Are you kidding? I like staying home instead of all the time going out. Not to mention saving $2 for the tickets and the babysitter. Unless you tell me I can't kiss my fiance on the Sabbath.
I would rather talk.
Uh-oh.
Charlie, I've seen that you wear a chain around your neck.
St. Christopher. He helped Jesus, as the story goes, when he was a boy across a flooded creek. So they made St. Christopher the patron saint of travelers. My mom gave it to me before I went overseas. So he'd keep an eye on me, get me back in one piece.
You believe that St. Christopher helped to bring you home?
Maybe so, maybe no. But I'm here. I'm not asking any questions. That was a joke.
I don't think that Emma should see her father wearing such a medal.
Okay.
But no, I don't want you to take it off if it offends your religion.
My religion wanted me to stay married to Caroline, which was hell on earth. Pardon my French.
Then why do you wear it?
It reminds me of my mom. But I can still remember my mom. Keep it in my dresser drawer.
Then you have no religion.
My religion wouldn't have me, is the way I see it.
I'm asking in seriousness. Do you believe nothing like Al?
No, I believe. Let's see, what do I believe? I believe try not to hurt anyone unless they're trying to hurt you. Always tell the truth, unless it hurts someone's feelings, but it's usually best to tell the truth all the time. And let's see. I believe, I'd say, try and always leave the world a better place.
Do you believe in God?
Why else would we be here? But I'd still believe all those things I just said, even if I didn't believe in God, so what does that make me?
I don't know.
Me neither. I see you worked at R.K. Brewer out in Jersey.
Yes.
I thought they went out of business during the Depression.
Oh, they did. It's been over 15 years since I worked there.
So what was your last job?
I was a business rep for Local 311.
Oh.
We're looking for drill, press, and lathe operators.
I'm your man.
You left a blank here where you're supposed to be down. Why you left your last job.
Time to move on.
This ain't a Western cowboy. We need employees we can rely on.
I'll work hard and keep my nose clean, guaranteed.
We're not looking for troublemakers. So you want to tell me again why you left your last job?
We work a rotating shift. First week, 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. Second week, 3 to midnight. Third week, midnight to 7. You got a problem with that schedule, Mr.
Khan? And it's no problem at all.
What's your first name?
Al.
Al Khan. Al Khan? Are you that commie union organizer?
What was I supposed to say? It's like asking a guy, does he still beat his wife? Even if he says no, he still sounds guilty. Anyway, I've had it up to here with jerks and yahoos and cretins. So I said to him, I am Al Khan, and I was a union organizer, but I didn't say whether I was or wasn't a communist, because it's nobody's damn business. Or aren't you familiar with the Constitution of the United States? That's when he hit me.
You could have gotten hurt.
I did get hurt.
I mean, more seriously.
I know what it's like to be Alice down the rabbit hole. I can't get hired unless I tell people about my last job. But if I tell people about my last job, I can't get hired.
It's only your first week out.
You think it'll get better?
I've been praying for you. And I have faith, even if you don't.
Well, you can't eat faith.
Father Dreyer put me in touch with Kevin Williams of Williams and O'Brien, and they have clerical work for me to do.
You?
Addressing envelopes at home, a penny apiece.
I'm sorry.
For what?
Everything.
Just because we're broke? And you can't get a job, and I don't get around the way I used to.
Yeah, I refuse to take the blame for the polio. And it was for better or for worse, wasn't it?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, it's only been for better or better.
Where's the baby?
With the grandmother. Not picking up any bad habits, I hope.
I would expect you would be more busier.
We were.
Did you do something wrong?
He sits there like a tiger, ready to pounce, making people think that we're doing something wrong. Thank you. You notice I didn't say come again.
Gina, would you like some fresh cobbler? Some soup?
Coffee, please.
Order the cobbler. We need the business.
And cobbler, please. And also, I would like to know, please, how your son is doing at college.
Oh, he's doing well. Thanks for asking.
He is eventually happy?
So he says.
But you're not sure.
Sure about what?
Would you say that Robert is happy?
He's top of his class.
Tell him I say mazel tov.
Thank you. I'll do that.
I ask about Robert, not to be rude, because he married a woman who is very different from him, because she's French and white. And I am wondering if it is a good thing to marry for love when there are other things that matter.
People have to marry for love.
That's true, but there's no doubt things would have been easier for Robert if he'd married one of his own.
How dare you say a thing like that as if it's Robert's fault? It's other people who caused the trouble.
That's why I said it's easier to marry one of your own.
Abel Davis? I don't believe you. You're the one that's always saying that things are gonna get better. Now you're saying that people should stick to their own kind. I don't believe my ears.
Gina was asking if people should marry only for love or to take other things into consideration. And I was saying, yes, that you should marry for love. But all things being equal, why not try to fall in love with someone that you have more in common with?
How much do two people have to have in common to fall in love?
Oh, do they have to be from the same state?
The same neighborhood.
Their age.
Oh, come on now, woman.
No, should they be the same age? A year apart? What about their height? You tell me what people have in common to fall in love.
You tell me that you don't cry yourself to sleep some nights over the problems that Robert and Perrette have.
Al, if the
there's one sure thing in this world. It's dirt. You clean it up, it always comes back. Ask any housewife, right, Miss Kay?
Right, Charlie.
Nothing stays clean. I mean nothing. Not you, not your floor, not your dog, not your car, not your teeth. As long as there's dirt, there's a need for fuller brushes.
I appreciate the effort, Charlie. Really, I do.
Some strings is all.
And I appreciate
it. There's not that many fuller brush roots available. Not much turnover.
And I appreciate that. I do. But, you know, as much as I admire the way you get out there and knock on doors, I just can't see myself selling brushes.
Are you kidding? You could sell snow to an Eskimo.
You could.
Is that a compliment?
You sold all of us on the union. I was dead set against it. Look at me now. I'm the president.
If you're equating the union with these brushes.
Don't get touchy, Al. All I'm suggesting is pretend you're selling the union. Substitute the word brushes. They both do a service for the community one way or another. Now, after all these years of working for peanuts, you deserve to earn a pretty penny from that gift of gab. Now, show people what a real capitalist you are. No offense.
Who is it?
Full of brush.
You must have read my mind. I need a mop.
Need a mop?
I threw the old one out yesterday. The handle was broken.
Well, I can certainly provide you with a mop.
Do I get a free letter opener?
The compliments of Al Kahn, your friendly, full of brush man.
Say, don't I know you?
No, but I hope we'll be doing lots of business together.
You say your name is Kahn.
That's right. And you are?
You're Al Kahn.
That's right. Mrs.
You're no fuller brush man. You're a communist. Take my name off that slip of paper. I'm not signing anything.
If you really believed I was a communist, you'd buy this mop from me just to make me a capitalist.
He found his calling. I feel it.
His calling?
Well, the thing he was meant to do.
You're saying that Al was meant to sell brushes?
Sell brushes, sell ideas, sell. Lord, I'd buy a brush from him if it would shut him up, wouldn't you?
How about you shut up and watch the picture, buddy?
All right, already. I'm in it.
The Nazi murder mill at hors d'oeuvre comes General Eisenhower with Generals Bradley and Patton. Shocked by unbelievable atrocities, the Supreme Allied Commander demands that all the world witness this German bestiality. So frightful that the strongest are sickened by this irrefutable proof. By trucks to this scene of organized death and terror are brought well-fed burghers and German officers. On orders of General Eisenhower, they're forced to look upon the evidence of indescribable human degradation. At the torture chamber, German witnesses need urging. Although this camp has flourished in their community through the 12 years Hitler has been in power, all they ever did was complain about the stench. One of the camp commanders balks at returning to the scene of his crimes. But the American MPs mean business. For American Medical Corps men, there's the gruesome job of care at Nordhausen. Starved beyond help, beyond hope, many rave in pain and torture. Human beings reduced to staring skeletons with only a spark of life left. Such brutality has aroused the anger of all the world.
Well, it's amazing how many people knew my name, or my face, or both, before I even uttered a peep. Well, the good news is, at least no one can accuse John Q. Public of not keeping up with current events.
I'm sorry things didn't work out.
Who said they didn't work out? People who thought it was a pinko didn't order anything. They might have bought flags if I was selling them, but not everyone knew who I was. Or at least not everyone brought it up. And lo and behold, when I did not get the door slammed in my face, a good number of people actually liked my pitch and placed some orders.
You're not just saying this to cheer me up.
Two hairbrushes, three mops, push broom, five toothbrushes. I figured for every door slammed in my face, I just have to knock on five more. Might take me a little longer to make the rounds than the other guys, but I've got nothing but time. And as I was hoping it door to door, I got to thinking, this isn't so bad. I could be my own boss, make my own schedule, meet new people. And if hard work figures into it, I might make a decent living at it. I gotta hand it to that Charlie Haley. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, Mrs. Barth. Yes, of course I remember you. You had a mop head replacement and two combs. Well, I enjoyed meeting you, too. Yes, I can cancel the order. No, don't apologize. Thank you for calling. Her husband recognized my name on the order form.
I'm so tired, I could fall asleep right here on the counter.
Oh, who could be calling this time of night? Oh. Rupert's.
Oh, Gloria. Thank goodness I found you. I've been trying you at home for hours, and then I remembered your little cafe.
Oh, good evening, Mrs. Sloan.
I'll need you and Abe to come in half an hour early tomorrow morning.
Come in half an hour early tomorrow?
The attic has to be put in order. I'm meeting with my lawyer on Tuesday, and I'll need a complete inventory.
That means we'll be able to leave a half an hour early.
I doubt you'll be finished by then. I'll see you at 7 sharp.
We'll be there.
Good night, Gloria.
Good night, Mrs. Sloan.
7 o'clock. That means we have to get up at 5?
That's the last straw.
Life is too short.
We can do half the business on weekdays here at Rupert's that we did today. One of us quits the Sloans, pinch every penny, squeeze every nickel.
And I can pinch and squeeze as well as anyone.
We'll need one steady paycheck and with a little bit of luck.
And with me working double time here at Rupert's.
Wait. What are you talking about? You work at double time. I'm the one who's quitting the Sloans.
Oh, no, I cannot work another day for those two.
You can't. You get along better with them than I do?
Me?
Yes.
Get along with Ruth Sloan? No, I have to pray to the good Lord every single day to give me strength to keep from slapping that woman. So
my attorney still hasn't received the number of your new bank account.
I don't intend to give it to you.
That's my money.
Our money.
I have my own records. I know to the penny how much we have.
Then you know to the penny how much this divorce is going to cost you.
You can't be granted a divorce if you can't prove grounds. And you can't prove anything against me because there's nothing to prove. I, on the other hand, can make an excellent case based on the grounds of fraud and mental cruelty. And I'm telling you right now, not only will I get back the money, I'm keeping the house, the Packard, and the Davises, too.
You can have your precious car, but I'm keeping the house and the Davises.
By what right?
I spent the last 25 years training them, and you are not going to reap the benefits of my labor.
Then we'll split them. I'll take Abe, you
they
take...
talk about us as if we're property.
It's obvious we can't settle this now.
Mr. and Mrs. Sloan.
Yes. A discussion is in order.
I beg pardon.
Gloria and I have decided that the time has come for us to open Rupert's on weekdays.
Well, why on earth?
Which means we are giving you our notice.
Effective, right now.
You're quitting?
Yes, sir.
The both of you?
Yes, ma'am. The both of us.
Charlie?
Hey! What are you doing here?
I must tell you, I cannot marry you.
What did I do?
Nothing.
Then what's the reason?
You're a Gentile.
You always knew I wasn't Jewish.
But before I thought it did not matter.
Well, then you were right about that.
I have decided that it does matter.
Crying out loud, Gina, you already married a Gentile. And his daddy was a Gentile, God rest his soul.
When I married Michael, I was happy to be alive. And I did not think that such things were important. But if Mike had not died, maybe eventually we would have not been happy. We did not have time to be not happy.
Holy cow.
I want my baby to live in a Jewish home.
So we'll have a Jewish home.
Charlie, I do not want to. I can't. To tell you all the time about everything, the traditions, the festivals. These are things that the Jewish father should know, that he should teach his children. I'm sorry. I'm very sorry.
How is your wife doing?
She'll be on the dance floor in no time.
Wonderful. Dr.
Green, you are needed. We'll be back in competition by next year.
I hope so. Mr. Khan, I know this has been a difficult time for you and your family, and the last thing I want to do is add to your worries, but
you want us to pay the bill.
The part not covered by your union insurance amounts to $153 for the week your wife was hospitalized.
Somebody ought to do something about those union benefits, huh?
And your last payment of $25 was 2 weeks ago.
Well, your money's been a little tight with the medication and all, but I will pay.
Can you tell me when?
When I can.
We do have a program which we administer jointly with County Memorial for indigent patients.
We're not indigent. We're just broke. Temporarily. Sorry. I'm sorry. It's not your fault. Thank you for your patience. I will get this bill paid very, very soon.
Thank you, Mr. Khan. I wish you and your wife the best of luck.
I know you need a short order cook. I'd appreciate it if you'd slide my name past the boss. Tell him I'm a fast learner. Remind him how fast I memorized the bar guide. There's certainly no danger of me quitting for a better job, and as long as I'm back in the kitchen, I can't scare off any customers.
You'd only be making half what you used to make as a bartender, and there won't be any tips.
Which is a hell of a lot more than I'm making right now.
All right, I'll see what I can do.
Thanks.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Sing hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. The sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land.
Maybe I could call it a superior. Gloria.
Now, remember to mind your manners.
Oh, come in. You can sit right over here. Coffee?
Two coffees. Four apple cobblers.
My word, Gus, I think we need to see a menu. The children have to eat lunch first. Keeps raving about your apple cobbler.
That's very kind of you. I hope it lives up to your expectations.
Oh, it will. Gus, take off your hat and smile, for goodness sakes. You don't want to scare away all the customers.
If you are truly a inventive homemaker, you'll never say die. Sometimes when you're frosting a cake, the icing is too hard, sometimes too soft. So, if your icing doesn't harden, gals, don't panic. Just put your Petit fours into your Beacon Deluxe refrigerator and they'll harden up in no time. The thing to remember about the Beacon Deluxe refrigerator is it has ThermoCool, which keeps your food fresh and tasty 24 hours a day. And there's plenty of storage space. And, oh, look, the icing's already hardened. And which is a good thing, because we're just about out of time. Just enough time for me to make that special announcement that I was planning to make. Arthur?
Oh, Arthur. He'll make Ginger a lovely husband, won't he, Jeff?
Ladies,
he's aces.
This is Arthur Schiller, my one and only, my fiancé I've told you so much about.
Hi, folks.
Heavens, you told me you were quite over her, but you sound ever so jealous.
Would you like another drink?
Yes, please.
Set our date, and we'll be getting married next week if Arthur doesn't get cold feet.
Not a chance.
Isn't he scrumptious, gals? I wish you all were as lucky as I am. Till then.
I love you so much. I think I'm going crazy when you say you won't marry me.
I'm sorry.
I'm not kidding, Gina. Genuine 100% crazy.
I can only say sorry.
Do you love me? You won't marry me because I'm not Jewish.
That's correct, yes.
If the mother makes the baby Jewish, then the father's religion doesn't matter. Uh-huh, don't say anything. I know I'm right. I hope you have a lot of babies, and I still hope they're mine, but whosoever they are, and as long as you're the mother, they'll all be Jewish babies anyway.
This is true. But I want my babies to have a Jewish father nonetheless. I want a Jewish home.
How a half-Jewish baby can be all Jewish and a half-Jewish household isn't Jewish doesn't make sense to me. But I'm beginning to see the picture. You made up your mind no matter what.
It's not that I don't want to marry you, Charlie. There's nobody I could love more. But I will not marry a Gentile. Of this, I am decided.
So you'll marry some guy you don't love just because he's Jewish?
No, I would have to love him. But he would have to be Jewish to understand my culture, my history.
You want your children raised Jewish? I'll raise them Jewish. I'll learn the language. Shalom. Yeah. You want a Jewish father? To make a 100% Jewish home? I'll convert.